morning everyone, welcome back to maths class. We are in block 6, in that we have completed S1, S2, S3. So today we are going to start our S4. Before going to learn our today's class, first we will recall yesterday's class. What did we learn in before classes, children? We have learned how to subtract the numbers. For example, I have given this problem on the board. See, 58 minus 4. How can we subtract 58 minus 4 by using column method, children? Yes, we have to represent the number by using place values first. So first ones and tens. So after writing place values, what we have to do? We have to assign the numbers under the place values. 58 and do we have tens in 4? No, there are no tens in 4. So what you have to keep under the tens place value? 0. And how many ones do we have? 4 ones. So we have to subtract. Now what is the symbol? Yes, minus. So subtract 8 minus 4. How can you subtract? Count from 4 until you get 8. 4 after 5, 6, 7, 8. So how many fingers have you opened? 4 fingers. So 8 minus 4, the answer is 4. Now 5 minus 0. So when we subtract 0 from any number, we will get same number as our answer. So 5 minus 0 is 5. So what is the answer, children? 50. What we will call this 54? Yes, the answer which we get after subtracting is called difference. Have you understood, children? What we will call the answer? We will call as difference. Let me take one more example. 63 minus 9. So, I want to subtract 9 from 63. How can I subtract, children? Yes, we have to use places first, then assign the number under the place values. Now, do we have tens in 9? No. So, put 0, then 9 under the ones place value. Now, subtract it. So, can you subtract 9 from 3? No, because 3 is small number and 9 is big number. That means we are subtracting big number from small number. Is it possible, children? No, it can't possible. We can't subtract big number from small number. So what we have to do? We have to regroup the numbers. Means we have to take borrow. Yes, what we have to take what we have to do, children? We have to take borrow. So from which number we have to take? Before number. So cut 6 and write before number. 6 before 5. And how much we should add to the present number here? We should add 10 to the present number. So 10 plus 3, 13. Now we have to subtract 9 from 30. Is it possible, children, now? Yes, we can subtract. So count from 9 until you get 30. 9 after 10, 11, 12, 13. How many fingers did I open? 4 fingers. So the answer is 4. Now, how much do we have here? 5 or 6? Yes, 5. Have cut 6, so here 5 is there. 5 minus 0 is 5. So the answer is 54. So what we will call this answer? Different. So see, children, I have written some problem on the board. What is that? So I have written word problem. So what we are going to learn today? Story problems. What is our S4, children? Story problems. So how we can solve story problems, children? So in before classes we have learned how to solve story problems, but we solve adding problems. In this class we are going to solve subtraction story problems. Which type of problems we are going to learn today? Subtraction story problems. So see, which I have written one problem on the board. Farhan has 26 chocolates. Farhan has 26 chocolates. She ate 9 of them. How many chocolates did she eat, children? 9 chocolates she ate. How many chocolates are left? So what we have to do? So she has some chocolates first. After that she ate some chocolates. So what we have to do? We should add 9 chocolates or we should remove 9 chocolates? Yes, we have to remove 9 chocolates because she ate. So we have to remove 9 from 26. So, can we subtract these numbers directly, children, in story problems? No, but we have to conclude the some story. So, what we have to do? We have to write number of total number of in addition story problems. Isn't it, children? Yes, we have written number of total number of in addition story problems. This is subtraction story problem. So what we have to do? Yes, we have to write total number of. We have to write reverse of the addition story problem. So total number of total answer. Total number of what she has children? Chocolates. So total number of chocolates. How many chocolates she has? 26 chocolates. So 26 chocolates she has now. Now, how many chocolates she ate? 9 chocolates. So total number of after what we have to write? Number of chocolates she ate. How many chocolates did she eat, children? 9 chocolates. Yes? Now what we have to do? We have to subtract 9 from 26. So now I am taking 9 ones and tens. 26 minus 9 we have to subtract. Yes, children? So subtract these numbers. I am subtracting here ones and tens. 26, 0, 9. So I hope you all habituated to write the numbers according to their place values. Now what we have to do? We have to subtract the numbers. So which place value we have to subtract? 1's place value. So which number do we have? 6 and 9. So we have to subtract 9 from 6. So here we have small number or big number? Small number. If we have small number, what we have to do? We have to regroup the numbers. Means we have to borrow the numbers. So cut 6 and cut 2, we have to take from 2. Yes? So cut before number 2 before 1. And how much do we have here? 16. Because we have to add 10 to the 6. 10 plus 6, 16. Now count from 9 until you get 16. 9 after 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. How many fingers do we have? 7 fingers. So, how much is there? 16 minus 9 is 7. Now, 1 minus 0. When we subtract 0 from any number, we will get same number. So, how many chocolates are left, children? 17 chocolates. So, total number of. Again, what we have to write for answer? Number of chocolates left. How many chocolates left, children? 70 chocolates left with her. Have you understood? Let me take one more example. See, children, one more problem. There are 28 balls. 5 of them are red. How many balls are not red? How many balls are there, children? 28 balls are there in total. So, in that, 5 balls are red. So how many are not red? We have to find out how many balls are not in red color. So what we have to do? We have to take out red color balls from the given balls. Means we have to remove red color balls. So then we will say how many balls are not red. So for that, what we have to write? We have to write some story answer. So how we have to solve story problems? Total number of. So, first we have to write T-O-T-A-L, total number of. Total number of balls. What are the children in the problem? Total number of balls. How many balls do we have? 28 balls are there. Yes? Next. 5 of them red. So, what we have to write? Number of red balls. Which color balls are there? Red balls. Number of red balls. How many red balls do we have? 5. So, 5 red balls. Now, what we have to do? We have to solve 28 minus 5. So, according to the place values, we can write the numbers and put 0 under the tens place value and 5 under the ones place value. Now, subtraction. So, what we have to do? We have to subtract ones place value. 8 minus 5. Can we subtract 5 from 8? Yes, this is big number only, so we can subtract it directly. So 8 minus 5, what children? Count from 5 until you get 8. 5 after 6, 7, 8. So answer is 3. Now 2 minus 0. 2 minus 0 is 2. So how many balls are not red, children? 23 balls are not in red color. So what we have to write in the answer? So number, total number of, in last we have to write number of not red balls. Total number of not red balls. How many balls are there? 23 balls are there extra, which are in not in red color. Have you understood, children? So we have to solve the problems like this. So let me take one more example. Now see, children, there are 29 students in a class. How many students are there, children? 29 students in a class, and 8 of them are boys. How many boys are there in that class? 8 members are there in that class. How many girls are there? So what we have to do? We have to remove boy number of boys from total number of students. Then we will get girls number. So what we have to write in solution? We have to write total number of students. How many students are there? Total number of students. How many students are there in that class? 29 students. Next, how many boys are there in that? 8 of them are boys. So what we have to say? Number of boys. How many boys are there in that class, children? 8 members. So 0 and 8, we can add, subtract them directly in that only. Now number of boys, 8 members. Next, what we have to find? Number of girls. So number of girls. So what we have to do to get girls? We have to subtract from 29, 8. So what is the symbol for subtraction? Minus. So what we have to do now? We have to subtract 8 from 29. So 9 minus 8. Can we subtract 9 minus 8? Yes. So big number is there at the top, so we can subtract. 9 minus 8 is 1. Now 2 minus 0? 2 minus 0 is 2. So how many girls are there in that class? 21 girls are there in that class. So when we have total number of something and remaining number, so we have to subtract to get the given answer. So have you understood, children, how you have to subtract the story problems? If it is addition story problem, we have to write number of, total number of. If it is subtraction story problem, so how can we know we have to subtract or add? Yes, by reading the problem we have to know how we have to subtract or not. Yes, if it is subtraction story problem, we have to write total number of. Have you understood, children? So now if I ask you to frame your story problem by using 26 and 8. So can you frame your story sum? Means you have to frame a question here. What you have to do, children? You have to frame a question by using this 26 and 8. So can you try, anyone? Yes. So we can say, I have 26 chocolates and I ate 8 chocolates. How many chocolates are left? Means we have to use subtraction story problem. Have you understood, children? Or we can say, I have 26 apples. My mother took 8 apples. How many apples are left with me? So you have to make a meaningful sentences by using these numbers, and you have to write a question here. Frame a story problem means what you have to do, children? You have to frame a question here. Now everyone, yes, Nana. Everyone open your volume. S4 solving word problems, page number 37. Everyone has to open your volumes and everyone has to complete your volumes, children. Now, first question is subtract using column method. Do you know how to subtract the numbers by using column method? Yes, you can subtract them easily. So, subtract them. Next, move to the second question. So, you have some story problems there. First one is, there are 24 slices in a loaf of bread.
8 of them have gone bad. How many slices are still good? So what you have to do? You have to subtract number of bad bread from total number of breads. So then you will get number of good breads. Now, second one. Lalit sold 39 juices on Monday and 5 juices on Tuesday. How many more juices did he sell on Monday? What you have to do here? You have to subtract 5 from 39. So, how you have to subtract subtraction story problems? You have to use total number of and number of. Next, move to the third one. Frame a word problem using 42 toys and 6 toys. Means what you have to write, children? Yes, you have to write a question there. So, everyone, complete your volume. Along with your volume, you have to complete your homework also, children. So, I have written your homework is on the board. So, volume S4 you have to complete and set 4 in page number 44. Everyone, complete your maths homework in your maths notebook, children. So, thank you.